things happening tonight. It's so lovely to be here with you. I'm playing repertoire. I suspect that many of you have not heard of these composers or have not heard these pieces before. So it's especially wonderful for me to be able to share them with you. I'm a big one for quotes. I find it fascinating what composers do with writing things that others quote, or they themselves quote from others. This is the first half of the dance concert hall program, and this part clearly is focusing on the dance aspect of things. So I have a quote for you by Erwin Schulhoff that he put in the score of the first page of the piece you're about to hear, the five jazz etudes. And he writes this, that music in that generation at that time were drawing sounds from Schoenberg and Bartok, and they were drawing excitement from it. And with all of the sounds going on, it was an exciting and fascinating time that they all wanted to embrace for that new decade of the early 20th century, or words to that effect. And what he was alluding to was that you had a new musical language in the 20th century. The composers that were coming up, Schoenberg and Bartok, and then passing on new ideas to their students, they were all about, it's a new century, it needs a new musical language, we can't continue the language from before. We don't necessarily discount it, but we have other things to say because life is changing. And with that, the composers that are following in that vein, it is not that they are academic composers, you know, studying to be serialists or studying to be primitivists. They were actually absorbing all of it. And that, of course, included that after World War I, you had American jazz making its way around Europe, and you had cabaret music being presented in the dance and cabaret halls. And so they didn't see one as being separate from another. They were all new sounds to be embraced. I have this personal pet peeve about the term classical music, because we tend to put it into a box and revere it. But if we think about how classical, you know, quote-unquote classical music has evolved, it has much more to do with the generosity and the embracing of all other kinds of music into it that lets it evolve from the medieval times through to today. And in that way, it's always living and it's always vibrant. And these composers absolutely picked up on this and were just grabbing all of it and including it as influence, as exciting sounds, exciting rhythms to embrace. We are getting into the Schulhoff part of this half, and we just heard Wilhelm Gross with five pieces using popular dances of the time, including dances named after cities that some of us are from. And in the second half, we have the five jazz etudes of Schulhoff. He uses a well-known popular tune, Kitten on the Keys, to end the set. It's hardly all that kittenish, but you'll see that for yourselves. And he also dedicates each of the movements to a particular jazzer that he knew